so many of my sisters and brothers are right now suffering under conditions that are far worse than those that I had to put up while I was in prison. My overall feeling about the acquittal is that the victory around my case means that there can be more victory. And all of the people, all of the sisters and brothers who came together in an organized fashion in order to demand my freedom can see now that it's possible to free more political prisoners and to do something about the oppression which has enslaved black people in this country for so long. We all recognize that the United States does not recognize the existence of political prisons. And in fact, in general, when you talk about a person who is arrested for political reasons, you're talking about the use of criminal charges in order to stifle leadership, in order to isolate leaders and activists from the community. There is that kind of political prison. You know about Bobby Seale and Erica Huggins and Huey Newton and Leotis Johnson, and I could go on and on and on. The list is endless. The Soledad Brothers. We know that they were arrested on criminal charges as an excuse for removing them from the community, removing them from their revolutionary work and activity among the people. But over the last few years, there has come into being another kind of political prison. And I'm talking about all of the sisters and brothers who are victims of the system, who are easy targets of the police, who get railroaded through the courts into prison, often for no reason at all, who are there only because they're black. And I think a brother during the Attica Rebellion sort of expressed this whole thing when he was asked by a reporter what he was charged with. And he said he was charged with being black. That's why he was there. And coupled with the oppression that leads black people and brown people, people of color, into the jails and prisons of this country, has been a new kind of political awareness that has spread all over the jails and prisons throughout the country. George Jackson, Fleeta Drumville, and John Cliche, and Rochelle McGee, I could go on and on and on to name the sisters and brothers who have achieved a political awareness and a political commitment behind the wall. But you see, once they do this, then they are subjected to all of the terror that the prison system has to offer. And so they end up spending years and years and years in prison under the worst of circumstances. The reason I am a communist is because I feel that only through a total revolution, which is going to overthrow the capitalist control of the economy, which will seize the wealth from all of the giant corporations that exploit and control the lives of all working people, but particularly black people. And see, I feel that the reason why racism is so blatant and has been a part of the history of black people from the time we were first kidnapped from the shores of Africa is because it has helped those capitalists gain more and more profit.